Hi there, I'm Michael with eTrailer.com. Today we're going to take a quick look at this Progressive Dynamics Pure Sine Wave Inverter with transfer switch and cord. This is a 1000 watt inverter that's going to provide that AC power to your electronics and appliances inside your RV. This Pure Wave technology is going to replicate the same AC current that you're used to in your household power. It's going to allow you to run your devices safely off of your 12-volt battery system. And because that pure sine wave technology is going to replicate that household type power, it's going to be perfect for your sensitive electronics like your HD TVs and computers. This is rated for 12 volts of direct current input and 120 volts of alternating current output. It's also rated for 1,000 watts of power output and 2,000 watts of starting power output. This does have an integrated 20 amp transfer switch that's automatically going to change from your inverter to shore power when you hook up at the campsite. This does include the 15 amp input cord. It makes it easy for you to hook up to that OEM receptacle coming from your distribution panel. So it's going to be one less thing that you have to hardwire in if you already have that OEM receptacle. Your connection points on the backside here, you've got your DC positive in, DC negative, so that you can get that hooked up to your battery system. This is a DC lug connection, so you're not going to need ring terminals or anything like that. It's going to be very easy to get that installed. Your vertical push-in AC connection is going to be inside here, so you will have to take this panel off to push those in to those vertical slots there, and that is not going to be GFCI compliant, so just get those put in to get connected to your AC out. This inverter should be mounted in a dry, well-ventilated space that's separate from your LP gas or battery compartments. So depending on where that distribution panel receptacle is, you want to make sure that you are getting this mounted in an appropriate location. As far as our dimensions go, this is going to be 11 3/8 of an inch long by 6 5/8 of an inch wide and 4 inches deep. Being that you do have to mount this in a separate compartment, they do include a 50-foot cable that will connect to this remote. That's going to allow you to control and monitor the inverter from a convenient location inside your RV. This control will display your input voltage, output voltage, any error codes that may pop up, that sort of thing. This is 4 inches wide by 2 3/4 of an inch tall, so it should be very easy to find a place to mount that to be sure that you're always aware of what's going on with your inverter here. Now, this does have several different safety devices. It's got a controlled fan that is going to be based on the temperature of the unit, so it's going to speed up when it needs to be cooled down a little bit more and slow down if it's doing fine, so that you're always getting the ideal temperature in there to prevent overheating. It's also got several built-in safety features, including reverse battery protection, so that you're not going to have to worry about your RV's electrical system being damaged. It's going to help protect that as well. This also has an auto restart function. If your power is interrupted, it will automatically restart for you. So it is going to help to make sure everything's running properly and smoothly for you. This is UL listed, so you can trust it's going to hold up well, do everything you need it to, and run properly. It is made here in the USA, so you can trust it is made to the high quality standards that we've come to know and trust for products that are made here in the US. As you're going to get it mounted, you can see we do have these mounting holes on the top here. So we'll just get our screws put in and slide it down, and then we'll have those connection points on the bottom as well. The remote is very easy to plug in with that cable. Just plug it in there, and then on the back side of the remote, just a simple spot to plug in there. They do include some instructions to help you get everything put together and installed properly. So overall, I think this is going to be a great option, specifically for those of you who have that OEM receptacle that's going right to your panel. This is going to make it a little bit easier for you, just one less thing to have to hardwire. So that's going to complete our look for today. Again, I'm Michael with eTrailer.com. Thanks for watching.